Today I'm making some donuts, and no, I'm not making the chocolate sprinkles or the cream filled. Those aren't good for you. I'm going to make a hollow form, and they're kind of fun because once you've got your donut made, then you can turn it into teapots or whatever. I made this a while ago. I call her her. She's got kind of a feminine energy, and it hasn't been fired yet, but I threw the donut and then threw this off the hump and that off the hump and pulled some handles. We'll get the donut made first, and I'll make a few pieces, and we'll trim it up and join it together. But let's get working with our donut first. So I've got this centered. As I said before, you guys don't want to watch me center. This is about 1400 grams of clay, or 3 pounds. And to make a donut, I like to open it right up in the middle, right down to the mat. So now it actually is a donut, but it's not hollow. And then I'm just going to open it right down to the mat, and I'm going to pull, just as I were making a pot, my finger, like I always do when I open my middle right finger to the palm of my left hand. Easy for me to say. So then I'm just going to open that up a little bit, and then I'm going to divide it in half. I'm just going to go down there. Now this is the bottom of your pot, so you'll want to make sure this part doesn't get too thin. And you can make these as big as and tall and round as you like. This one I made, I showed you, was kind of small, not a very big donut. And since I like donuts, I'm making a big donut. And I like to throw the inside part first. Well, that was rude. I like to throw the inside part first because it's easier to get over this if it's thrown. And I'm going to clean that up. So this is the inside part to the donut. And it got a little uneven on top. I like it to be tidy. I'm just going to level that off. And smooth it out, and I think that's probably tall enough. And now I'm going to throw the outside part. Notice I'm not going really fast. And also what you can't notice is when I was wedging, I have a lump of something in there. Should fire the wedger. It would make me very happy. Okay, so now we have the inside and the outside. And obviously the taller the inside and the outside, the bigger around your donut is. So now I'm going to just start bringing my inside toward my outside and my outside toward my inside. And just get them to work together. Just get them to work together. Start singing the Beatles, come together right now. There they are. Just let them have, clay has its own rhythm and time if you just let it go. Now you've got this nice sealed form. Some people like to run a metal rib over it. I'm not a big rib user, but it can sort of tidy that up a little bit. And now I'm going to cut the outside. And the inside a little tidier. I'm not going to worry about taking that out right now, because what I'm going to do is I'm going to undercut it with the wire and it'll all come apart. You'll see it tomorrow when I come back. It'll all come together. Or come apart or whatever. So there we are. That's the first stage of throwing the donut. And then tomorrow I'll trim this up and I'll put on some pieces, but I have to make the pieces first. we're going to start making a Stanford. I'm going to make this is a bigger ball of clay for a bigger donut. This is a smaller for a smaller one. I've worked off the hump before. There are links below. There's making bowls and little jam pot lids, but this is mostly centered. This is centered, and I'm just going to throw this upside down. So this part, when I'm done, goes on the table, and this part attaches to the donut. So I'm just going to open it up like a bowl. I'm going to throw a stand. Now I want this to be, don't worry about thick. I want this to be a little bit thick because it's the foundation, it's the base. How big do I want? So what I'm going to do is just going to give it some definition. There we go. And I've got lots of clay there to join on and to work with. Give that some define. There we go. Make sure there's no water in it. And undercut it and take it off just like I did in the bowls in the links below. You can take that off. And then I'm going to give it a handle. And put it in the trough, cross the wires. I always like to pull the bottom one. And then I could probably pick that up and not smudge it, but I'm going to give it, so when I stick my fingers in there to grab it, I got a hold of it under there. And I have somewhere to go. I always like to put in the paper. Sometimes the clay will stick to the board. A paper stops it from sticking. So, okay, so there's a base. Now maybe we want to make a neck for it. So again, a neck would just be a top thing again. I centered it, open it up like I would the bowls, and throw. I'm just gonna throw a tall neck. And I'm gonna mimic the top of this neck to the base of that so they have the same shape. I'm gonna give it a little bit more pizzazz. Skinnier waist. There we go. So they're the same, kind of the same shape, top and bottom. That'll bring it together. That's one way you can do that. And I've got water down there, but it doesn't matter because if it eats the bottom of the pot, I'm going to cut it hollow anyway. So I'm not going to try to get down there and clean it up. And it cut through, so it doesn't matter. And it's nice to have this piece on now because the top of the vase is hollow, so if you tried to pick it up, it would squish and flatten. So that's one way you could make, we talked about in the links below some jam pots. So you could do like a lid for this with the same way. You could open up a cylinder and kind of like the same as a jam pot, make a tall, skinny jam pot. And sometimes a funky lid is nice on one of these, so a little wide base. And I'm going to bend that over. In the same way I did, I'm just going to make a little trough in there. I don't want to put a lid on this one, but it's an option. Make that a little taller, a little thinner. I'm not sure why it would have a lid. A lid with rhythm. There we go. So if I were going to do that, I would measure it with my calipers, and we'll take that off, and I'll just quickly throw. So you can see where you could choose to do whatever you like. You can throw a spout for it and make it a teapot. You can do whatever you're allowed to like what you like. So I'll take that off. and put it with them. And we're gonna pretend I measured, so I'm not gonna use a lid, but I would throw a little lid for that. And I'll make the lid the same way I did the jam pot lids. And we can talk about different lids in a different video. And that's why I'm not gonna throw a spout and all of that for a teapot. Teapot's another video, another time. But we could just throw a little lid for that guy. I'm not gonna take a lot of time. And he could have a little lid that fit on there. Is that gonna fit? Nope. But you get, anyway, so you just build the pieces. And I'm not sure if he's gonna have handles. A lot of these times when you're making these pots, you don't really know what you're gonna make until you get there. The clay will say, I wanna be this. So what I'll do is I'll make this little lid, take it off, and I'll pull the handles later. I don't know if it wants handles. But there's the lid. And as I said when I was making the jam pots, this clay under here is not wasted. It doesn't take long before you can just lift that up and take back your little piece of clay here and put it back in your wedging, and it's not completely wasted. Let's see if it fits without measuring, just for the heck of it. Oh, it won't even come off of there. Okay, that wasn't a good idea. Anyway, you can see where you can put that on your donut with a lid. And that might be kind of cool too, on the top of your donut. I'd wait till it was a little bit drier. Anyway, so we've got some ideas here. I'm going to use those two pieces to finish the form, and that will probably be it in another video. So we've talked about donuts today, and lids, and we'll come back and finish it up, and we'll make it into something that will be wonderful, perhaps. I threw the donut yesterday, and I threw these pieces to go with it. Now I'm gonna trim the bottom first just because you gotta start somewhere. And this has quite a bit of clay here. Notice it is solid. So when I'm building, if I decide to cut the donut flat to put it on there, I can open up the circle and it won't matter. But I do wanna get rid of some clay here. So I'm just gonna trim it up. Well, that was rude. Okay, we're back. Now that happens when I take too long getting ready and center this and yammer on, and we have to wait for me to ready for camera. The board dried out, the bat dried out, but we're here now and we're centered again, and we're not dry. So I'm just gonna get rid of some of that extra clay there just to give it a bit more flair. Notice when I'm trimming, my hands are joined, and there's a direct relationship between the, I'm pushing down as hard here as I'm pushing against, and theoretically, it shouldn't come flying off like that. I just waited too long. I did that to show you what would happen. You dilly-dally when you're trimming. So I think I'll leave it there. And just take this off and trim the top. Kind of wrecked this. It was soft when I took it off the bat, and it kind of got munged a bit. And it's more of that technical pottery talk. It's a little munged, so I'm just going to see if I can bring it back. There we go, it's level. And I'm going to trim it a little bit just to tidy it up. It's messy in there from being munged. And I'm going to give it a bit more just line. Okay, that's pretty good. I was more concerned about being level and not munged. And I'm going to take this guy off. And gonna trim the donut. Now I threw this side. I'm gonna trim the bottom first. We'll get centered. Okay, we're centered. And I'm just gonna tidy that up. Now I've got quite a bit of clay here, so we can be fairly liberal with our trimming and get a nice round donut. It is pretty wet. Alrighty, so there we got that side done. I'm gonna turn it over and trim the other side. Get that centered. Okay, so now I get to decide if I like this or not. And I'm going to work here, I think, on the wheel. So that's what we're going to do. I'm not going to build it on the wheel. It'll take me a while. I will cut the bottom flat to go on there and have to open the donut, and I'll put my top on directly on top. Building's going to take a while. What I'll do is I'll take a picture when I'm done and I'll show you. I think I will put some handles here. But one thing I wanted to show you about attitude a little bit, like if I do this, it just looks like a vase. If I do this, it's a questioning vase. If I do this, it's a, I don't know, confident vase. Angry vase. You can give us some tilt and some attitude, but I'm not going to take the time because you probably wouldn't watch me anyway. But I'm going to build one of those, and we come back and I'll have put it together. It's just a matter of building. I'll cut a hole here to put the vase all the way through. I'll cut it flat there. It'll sit on the flat base, and I'll decide later about handles, but they're not pulled yet. So anyway, so that's what you do. You through the three pieces, you build them together and decide if that's the shape you like. If it isn't, I could go, I don't like that, and build some more pieces. At this point, it's whatever you like. So here we are. Done. One thing I forgot to mention is that after you finish throwing it and before you set it aside to dry, poke a hole in the donut. There's air trapped in there. You have to let the air escape as the clay dries and shrinks. So I put the bottom on like I said I would, put the top on, pulled a couple handles and put them on the shoulder. Now this one doesn't have any attitude, but the one in the back does. The one in the back is bisque, waiting to be glazed. This one is still wet. But it's done, it's finished. I'll put it in the drying cupboard. I'll dry it slowly. It has thick and thin, and I'll show you later on, maybe. But it looks like when it's done. If you do like this, I'd like you to hit the like. And if you want to see me make more stuff, finished or not finished, hit the subscribe. If you have any comments, I would love to hear from you. And thanks ever so much for watching.